Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn a very interesting story from our supplemental reader, that is Chapter 5, Golu Grows a Nose. This is written by Rudyard Kipling. His full name is Joseph Rudyard Kipling. He was born on 30th December 1865 in Mumbai. Rudyard Kipling was an American journalist, short story writer, poet and also a novelist. Now coming to his works, The Jungle Book, Mowgli, Legend of the Jungle, Adventures of Mowgli. These are his famous books and these have been produced as movies. Now, coming to his poems. He is famous for the poems If, The White Man's Burden, Fuzzy Wuzzy, Boots, etc. Coming to his short stories. He is very famous for the short stories like The Man Who Would Be King, Rikki Tikki Tavi and Mowgli's Brothers. He has won Nobel Prize in Literature. Unfortunately, on 18 January 1936, he passed away in London. Now, let us read the lesson. Golu Grows a Nose. This story tells us how the elephant got its trunk. Let us read the lesson. Long, long ago, the elephant had no trunk. He had only a bulgy nose as big as a boot. He could wiggle it from side to side, but couldn't pick up things with it. So here we come across the difficult words, that is bulgy. Bulgy means swelled up. Wiggle means twist. So long, long ago, what happened? The elephant had no trunk. Trunk is the nose of the elephant. And he had only a bulgy nose. So swelled up nose only it had. And that was compared to as big as a boot. It was compared to a boot. And he could wiggle it. In order to pick up the things, he used to wiggle it with his nose. But he couldn't pick up anything. There was a baby elephant called Golu. So now we are talking about Golu. So Golu is a baby elephant. He too had no trunk but only a bulgy nose as small as a small boot. So this small baby elephant also had a bulgy nose and that nose is compared to a small boot. Golu was full of questions. He asked his tall aunt, the ostrich, "Why don't you ever fly like other birds?" So Golu is very curious to know the things. And it asked his aunt, that is ostrich, "Why don't you ever fly like other birds?" Then he asked his tall uncle, the giraffe, "What makes your skin so spotty?" So it asked his uncle, that is giraffe, and what that is, why your body is full of spots. He asked his huge uncle, the hippopotamus, "Why are your eyes always so red?" So now it asked its uncle. So who is Golu's uncle? Hippopotamus. So what did it ask? "Why are your eyes always so red?" He asked his hairy uncle, the baboon, "Why do melons taste like melons?" The ostrich, the giraffe, the hippopotamus and the baboon had no answers to Golu's question. "Golu is a naughty baby," they said. He asks such difficult questions. So here, Golu is very curious to know the things. Always it asks some of the other questions to the animals. And they are unable to answer the questions. So at first, to whom did it ask? First, it asked the ostrich. Later on, it asked the giraffe. So to giraffe, what did it ask? "Why is your skin so spotty?" And later, the huge uncle hippopotamus, what did it ask? "Why are your eyes so red?" And later, the baboon. So baboon is the hairy uncle of this Golu. And what did it ask? "Why do melons taste like melons?" So these melons fruits, why do they taste like melons only? So all these animals, that is the bird, ostrich, giraffe, the hippopotamus and the baboon, they had no answers to the questions asked by Golu. And they said, "Golu is a naughty baby," they said. So it is very naughty and very curious to know the answers from them. So always he asks such difficult questions. Now let us see the next paragraph. One day Golu met the Myna bird sitting in the middle of a bush and he asked her, "What does the crocodile have for dinner?" The Myna said, "Go to the banks of the great grassy Limpopo river and find out." Now next Golu met Myna. So Myna is the bird. So what did it ask? Myna is a singing bird. So what did it ask Myna? That what does the crocodile have for dinner? So crocodile, night time dinner, what does it will have? So Myna doesn't know the answer. So it says, "You go to the banks of the great grassy Limpopo river and find out." So that means there near that Limpopo river, in that river, who stays crocodile? So you go there and ask the asked this crocodile. Golu went home. He took 100 sugar canes, 50 dozen bananas, and 25 melons. Then he said to his family, "Goodbye. I am going to the great grassy Limpopo River. I will find out what the crocodile has for dinner." After packing all the things, it said goodbye to his family and it started moving to the great Limpopo River, and "I will find out." So it started moving to that river and it wanted to find out what that crocodile has for dinner. He had never seen a crocodile and did not know what one looked like. So this Golu did not even see this crocodile, and he did not even know how it looks like. Then on the way, he met a python and asked him. So it is very curious to know, how does this crocodile look like? So, "Have you ever seen a crocodile? What does he look like? What does he have for dinner?" So all these questions it asked this python. So this python will see whether this python knows these answers for this Golu's questions or not. The python uncoiled himself from the branch of a tree but said nothing. Golu politely helped him to coil around the branch again and said goodbye to him. So here, uncoil means become straight. So the python uncoiled himself from the branch of the tree, and then it said it did not answer to Golu's question. And finally, Golu helped this python to coil round the branch, and it said goodbye to python and started moving. Golu moved on, eating sugar canes, bananas and melons. After a few days, he reached the very edge of the great grassy Limpopo River. On the bank of the river, he saw a log of wood. So finally, this Golu moved on. And on the way, as it was very hungry, it started eating what all the things it has brought. So what did it bring? It brought melons, bananas and sugar canes. All this it ate, and finally it reached the edge of the river. And what is the name of the river? That is Limpopo River. Edge means bank. So on the bank of the river, it saw the log of wood. It was really the crocodile who winked at him. "Excuse me," said Golu. "Have you ever seen a crocodile?" So here wink means opening and closing the eyes very quickly. So it had seen this, Golu had seen the crocodile. It was crocodile, but Golu doesn't know that it was crocodile. The crocodile winked again and lifted half his tail out of the mud. "Come here, little one," said the crocodile. "Why do you ask such questions?" So here this Golu went to that bank of the river. There the crocodile was in that river, and it has lifted its tail up, and it was asking this question. That is, it wanted to know where is this crocodile. So the crocodile called him and, "Come here, dear," it said. "Come here, little one," said this crocodile. "Why do you ask such questions?" So why you want to know such questions? "I want to know." So who said this "I want to know"? Golu. "Come close, little one, for I am the crocodile." And he shed crocodile tears. Shed crocodile tears means false tears. So it said that, "I am the crocodile, you come here," okay, to show it was quite true. So it shed crocodile tears and it wanted to show that it was true crocodile. So how does this crocodile show that it was true crocodile? Let us see what it is. Golu was afraid, but he sat down on the bank and said, "You are the very person I was looking for. Please tell me what you have for dinner." So now Golu, it was very afraid to go near to this crocodile to talk to it. And finally, it sat on the bank of the river and it said, "So are you the crocodile? So if you are the crocodile, then I wanted to know what you will have for dinner. Come here, little one, and I will whisper the answer to you," said the crocodile. So whisper means to talk, to speak in a very low voice. "So you come here, I'll whisper in your ear." And it said, Golu put his head down close to the crocodile, snout, and the crocodile caught him by the nose. So what happened? This Golu went near to the crocodile, and when it went very near to the crocodile to hear, then immediately the crocodile with its mouth, it has caught the Golu's nose. "I think," said the crocodile, "today baby elephant will be my dinner." So crocodile said that, "Today I think this baby elephant will be my dinner." "Let me go, you are hurting me, Mr. Crocodile," screamed Golu. Scream is cried. So it is hurting. So what is hurting for Golu? So this crocodile, it opened its mouth and it wanted to catch hold of this Golu. So in order to take full, instead of that, it has just picked up the nose and it was pulling it. So Golu got hurt, and it was asking, it was crying, screaming, and it was asking it to leave it. The python, who had been quietly following Golu, came to the bank and said, "If you do not pull as hard as you can, the crocodile will drag you into the stream." So python, on the way it has met, no, it was following Golu, and python from the back, it said that if you don't pull yourself back, then this crocodile will eat you off, or it will take you into that stream. Drag you means pull you into the stream. Golu sat back on his little haunches and pulled and pulled. So haunches refers to part of the hip. So it sat and it was pulling it back, and from there the crocodile was pulling its nose. The crocodile slipped into the water, making it all creamy with the great sweeps of his tail, and he also pulled and pulled. So the crocodile slipped into means went into without any effort. The water, making it all creamy. So when all the time this crocodile will be in the water, so everything is creamy. Creamy means full of bubbles. With great sweeps of his tail, sweeps means strokes, and also he also pulled and pulled. So this crocodile was pulling, and even this elephant was also pulling. Then the python coiled himself round the Golu's stomach and said, "Let's pull harder." So this python, what it did, it coiled round the Golu's stomach, and this python was also helping Golu to pull it back, and even the crocodile was also trying to pull this Golu. Golu dug in all his four legs in the mud and pulled. So dug in all his four legs means it was just standing over there, and it was just pulling itself back. It wanted to go back. The nose kept on stretching. So when it was going back, when Golu was going back, the nose which was caught by this crocodile, and that was stretching. When Golu was going back, the nose was stretching. At each pull, the nose grew longer and longer, and it hurt Golu. So each and every pull, when this Golu was moving back, the nose was becoming longer and longer, and it has hurt Golu a lot. The nose was now 5 feet long, but it was free at last. So that when it was in that stretching, how many feet it did become? It became 5 feet, and it was stretched a lot, and it got some hurt, and it went back finally. Golu sat down with his nose wrapped up in a banana leaf and hung it in the great grassy Limpopo river to cool. So Golu, that nose when it was stretched, it was hurting her, and what did he do? It wrapped means, you can see, covered up. Wrap is to cover up. It covered up its nose with a banana leaf, and it kept its nose in that Limpopo river. Why did it keep? In order to make it cool. Golu sat there for two days waiting for his nose to cool and to shrink. It grew cool, but it did not shrink. Shrink means to reduce in the size. So 2 days it kept its nose in that water. Why did it keep? It was hurting. Okay, it was hurting very badly, so it has kept. But that hurt, finally it was okay, the pain has gone. But did that nose came back? No, it was like that only. It was very tall, it was very long, and how many feet it was? It was 5 feet. At the end of the second day, a fly came and stung Golu on the shoulder. Golu lifted his long nose, that is trunk, and with it hit the fly dead. So what happened on the second day? Fly came and it sat on the shoulder of Golu. And what that fly was doing? It was pricking Golu. So immediately Golu has lifted its trunk, or this nose which has become trunk, which has become very long, that is 5 feet. So with it, it has flapped on the fly, and immediately the fly died. Advantage number one, hissed the python. So hissed means the sound made by the snake. So the python said, this is the advantage of it. So what is the advantage? As Golu has a long nose, that is the trunk, with the help of its trunk, it was able to flap on the fly, and the fly was dead. You couldn't have done it with a small nose. Try and eat a little now. So it said that with small nose, you couldn't have done it. So now you try and start eating something. So at the beginning, it was unable to pick up the things with the small nose. So now the python advised Golu to pick up something and start eating. Golu put out his trunk and pulled a large bundle of grass. He dusted it against his forelegs and stuffed it into his mouth. So now what did Golu do? Golu, with the help of its trunk, with the help of its long nose, it has plucked a bundle of grass and that it has dusted near its forelegs and it stuffed into its mouth. Okay, advantage number two is the python. So this is the second advantage of having a long nose, having a trunk. You couldn't have done it with a small nose. Don't you think the sun is too hot now? So now python says that with small nose you couldn't have eaten properly. Okay, now with this long nose, this is an advantage for you. With this long nose, you are able to put the grass into your mouth. And now it says that, don't you think that the sun is very hot? So now we'll see what Golu does with this. Golu scooped up some mud from the bank and slapped it on his head. So what scooped up means? Took up. So Golu went to the bank of the river. There, from there some mud, it has picked it up. As it is very hot, that mud it has taken from the bank of the river and slammed it on his head. So it has threw on its back. Advantage number three is the python. You couldn't have done it with a small nose. So if Golu had a small nose, will it be able to pick up the mud and put it on his back? No, it couldn't have done it. So this is the advantage number three, that Golu was able to take out the mud with its trunk and it has threw on its back to protect itself from the heat. Thank you, Mr. Python, said Golu gratefully. I will remember all this and now I will go back to my family. So here gratefully refers to thankfully. So it says, Golu says thank you to Python and finally it remembers all this. So what all it does remember? All the three advantages of having the trunk. It remembers and finally it goes back to its family. What did you learn from this story? Yes, curiosity to know things is well and good, but trusting strangers is sometimes dangerous. Here in this story, Golu's curiosity has helped it a lot by having a long nose. Is it clear, children? Have you all understood? Thank you.